In this video, we are going to discuss about fopen function as well as file modes. Mainly there are two types of files are present. First one is text file, second one is binary file. So here we will discuss about what are the text file modes as well as what are the binary file modes. First let's see what is fopen function. Before that let's see how to declare a file. Here we can declare a file with the help of file in uppercase letters, space file pointer, so aspic file pointer. So this is for declaration of a file. So once a file pointer is declared, then we have to open the file with the help of fopen function. So fopen function is useful in order to open a file for reading or writing the data. Fopen function accepts two arguments. The first argument is file name with extension, whereas the second argument is within the double quotation mode. So how to open a file? File pointer is equal to fopen of within the double quotations file name comma within the double quotations mode. Fopen function is mainly useful in order to open a file for reading the data or for writing the data into the file. So fopen function accepts two parameters. We need to specify the file name with the extension. If it is a C file, then we have to specify the extension as .c. If it is a text file, .txt, like that. And we need to specify the mode within the double quotations. Now let's see what are the modes that are available. Here we have two types of file modes are there. First one is text file modes and the second one is binary file modes. First let's see about text file modes. Totally here we have six modes are present. The first one is R. R stands for read. The second one is W. So W stands for write. Third one is A. A stands for append. Next, fourth one is R plus. So R plus stands for read as well as append. So it performs both operations. And the next one is W plus. W plus stands for write and read. So it performs both operations. And the last one is A plus. A plus means append plus read. It performs both operations. So first let's see the first one. So what is the first one? R. So R stands for read. Let us take an example here. Fp is equal to fopen of, let name of the file is sample.csc, sample.c, let it be some C file comma. What is the mode here? A read mode. So within the double quotations R. So R, read mode. Read mode opens a file for reading data from the file. So if we want to read data from the file, then we have to open the file in read mode. Suppose if the file doesn't exist, then fopen function returns null to the file pointer. So here, what is the file here? Sample.c is the file name. So if this file doesn't exist, then fopen function returns null value to the file pointer. Okay, so this is about R mode. So what is the use of R mode? R allows us to open a file in read mode so that we can read data from the file. If there is no such file with that name, then fopen function returns null to the file pointer. So this is about read mode. Now let's see the second one. The second one is W mode. So now in place of R, we have to use this W. So W mode opens a file for writing data into the file. So if we want to write any data into the file, then we have to open the file in write mode. Suppose if the file doesn't exist, then a new file will be created with this name. Assumes that sample.c is not available. Now with sample.c, a new file will be created. Assumes that sample.c is already available. That means if the file is already available, then its contents then the file contents will be overwritten. Okay, let us assume that here we have some ABC. Okay, and now let us assume that we want to write 1, 2, 3 there. So now ABC will be overwritten with 1, 2, 3. So this is about write mode. So here simply there are three important points. The first important point is W allows us to write data into the file. That is the first important point. Second important point here is, if the file doesn't exist, then a new file will be created with this name. And the third important point is, if the file already exists, then the corresponding file content will be overwritten. Now let's see about the third one. The third one is A. A stands for append mode. So now here we have to use A for append. Okay, so append mode allows us to append data to the end of the file. So by using append mode, we can open a file in append mode. So append mode allows us to append data to the end of the existing file. Let us assume that this file already existed, then the new content will be appended at the end of the existing file. Suppose with this name there is no such file available, then a new file will be created. So here the major difference between write mode and append mode is, if he uses write mode, if the file exists, then the corresponding file's content will be overwritten. Whereas if he uses append mode, if the file exists, then the corresponding content will be appended to the end of the file. So at the end of the existing file, then the new content will be appended. Let the file contains 1, 2, 3. And let us assume that we want to append ABC. Now ABC will be appended at the end of the existing file. So this is about append mode. And the next one is R plus. So the name itself specifies the meaning. If we open a file with the help of R plus mode, then we can perform read operation as well as append operation. Next one is W plus. If we open a file in W plus mode, then we can perform write operation as well as read operation. Next one, A plus. If we open a file with the help of A plus mode, then we can perform append operation as well as read operation. So this is about text file modes. Now let's see about binary file modes. Okay, binary file modes. Binary file modes are also similar to the text file modes, but after R we have to use as B. After each letter we have to use as B, where B stands for binary file. So here the first one is RB. So RB stands for what? Read operation on binary file. Second one is WB. WB stands for write operation on the binary file. Third one is AB. So AB stands for append operation on binary file. So fourth one, RB plus R, we can write it as R plus B. So RB plus means what? What is the meaning here? Read plus append. Read plus append. We can write RB plus as R plus B also. And the next one is WB plus R. This can also be written as W plus B. So what is WB plus write plus read? We can perform both these operations. And the next one is AB plus. AB plus can also be written as A plus B. So what is the meaning here? Append plus read. Okay. So RB is similar to the read mode. So what is RB here? This mode opens a file for reading. If the file name doesn't exist, so here we have to use this word RB. It is which file? Binary file. So binary file means, let us assume that here we have some .exe file. The best example for binary file is .exe file, executable file. Executable file means it is in the form of zeros and ones. Okay. So RB mode allows us to open a file for reading the data. So with the help of RB, we can read some data from the binary file. Suppose if the file doesn't exist, then fopen function returns null to the file pointer. And what is the second one? WB. WB is similar to the write mode. Okay. So WB opens a file for writing data into the file. If the file doesn't exist, then a new file will be created with this name. If the file already existed, then its contents will be overwritten. And the next one is AB. So this mode allows us to open a file for appending the data to the end of the existing file. So if this file doesn't exist, then a new file will be created with this name. Suppose if the file already exists, then the new content will be appended to the end of the existing file. And then we have RB plus, or we can write it as R plus B. So RB plus means we can perform read and append. WB plus means we can perform write and read. AB plus means we can perform append and read. So this is about fopen function, as well as file modes such as text file mode as well as binary file modes.